You're about to watch a free 5-minute sample of a live training video. At the end of the video, I'll tell you where to watch the whole thing, or just scroll down for more info. I'll see you in 5 minutes. Look at that, it's me against a green screen. Have you ever seen anything more terrifying? Let me show you the clip that I shot. I did a little, just a quick little test shot in the studio so that I could have something to key with. And you'll see that it is me with, here, let's just open this up nice and big, with the green screen behind. I thought I'd have a little fun with it, you know, start wide and kind of go back and then I come in and zoom in. So we got a patch of the shot that is green and then eventually zoom in. And there we go, the whole thing is green. And then just because you can, so we can see how it goes through the beard, if it does a good job of that or not, because I don't have any hair. Then we rotate it around and flip it over to blue screen, ooh, which apparently already has the key on it. Let me back out of there. Ooh, giving that away, didn't realize that was already on there. Let's just get rid of that. Everybody close your eyes, just don't look right now. There we go, and then there's the blue part, so we can keep playing through that. So I flip it around, we got the blue side, and away we go. And then we got a blue key, because it does, well, it can key any color, really. There's an eyedropper, you can key any color you want to. So if you wanted to key fuchsia, because that's what you had, then you could. But we are going to do this with green and blue because that's pretty much standard. So here's what I'll tell you right off. The keyer is reasonable. It's not the greatest keyer in the world. It's certainly missing some kind of higher end features. I would say this is probably not, it's probably not a finishing keyer unless you're keying graphics. Like if you rendered out a graphic and you rendered against a green background, then this would do fine, especially if there's no aliasing. If there's aliasing, you might still get a little fuzzies. I didn't actually try doing that. The aliasing might turn out okay. But if you have no aliasing, then you're gonna be totally fine. However, for a real world scene like this, you're gonna see it's okay. So let's see what we've got. I built a background layer here, which I'm actually gonna hide for the moment here. Let me just get this out of the way completely. Oh, I guess I can't do that, can I? I have to move this. Let's move that shot over. I'll move this shot over. We'll just put it down there. And then I'm gonna put it back up on top of the background layer. But let's take a look at how it's done. Double tap like everything else to get into the keying controls, into all the controls. Over on the right side, you have your color and effects. And up at the top, and once again, like every other show this entire series, I have forgotten to turn on touches. So here we go, into help, show touches. Now you can see what I'm touching. All right, let's go back into that again. Double tap on there. Down at the bottom, there's our color and effects tab. Up in the top right of this, you see all the different controls that you've got and the keyhole, get it? The keyhole is our key. That's the one that we want. So now these are all the same tool. Like we saw in many of the color correcting tools, the filter tools and so on, what we're seeing here are 6 different presets, or not 6 different tools. If I click on any of these, they do not add another tool, they just replace the one that's there because it is the same tool with the different preset. You can see up there at the top, there's the first one's called green screen key and then blue screen, dark lumen, and a few other things. Again, all presets. So if I tap on green screen key, just like that, it does its best possible job off of a generic green color. And you can see the color. At the right, it says key color. And if I turn this off, I'm gonna disable it by tapping the little eye there. We can see that the key color doesn't exactly match the actual background color perfectly. So that's gonna be the first thing it will fix. I'm actually gonna scrub in a little bit to the point where I'm filling the screen. And then once we'll go back and play with it some more with the kind of play it back with the non-filled screen. But we can see the key colors don't exactly match. So that's gonna be my first step. So this is one of those little tips. So this, by the way, what you're seeing right now, that's just native out of the box, drag it on, done nothing. Which is pretty good, but it's not perfect. Right now, if I wanted to sample the color, so there's the eyedropper there, I tap that and I drag it, but then you're going, hold on, where's the green that I'm sampling? I mean, I could sample my skin color, that would be, you could do that, that's actually kind of cool. You could do that and then grab the eyedropper and go back to the green, but if sampling that skin color had, or whatever color you sampled, somehow kind of reached into the green a little bit, you may not have your solid. The way you want to do this is disable the filter. Disable the effect. So tap the little eye right there, just tap that so it's disabled. And now I can sample that background color. So now I'm gonna grab that eyedropper, drag it over there, and drag it on. So now I know that I'm sampling the exact color. And then when I hit the eye again to re-enable it, now we're seeing the final results of that. So without doing anything else, so my hue, saturation, brightness range are all at their default position. We can play that and see how it looks. And you know, we're looking against a black background now. We can definitely see some holes, like in the shirt, there's some stuff going on in there. And I think a good way to test it is to reverse it. So at the bottom, you got a reverse key. If I hit that, I can see the reverse of it, and now I can see, oh yeah, there's definitely some holes in the shirt. So what I was doing when playing with this was I'd keep toggling back and forth between them to try and find that optimal key. Now, again, we are not going to eliminate the green completely. This is not going to be a perfect key. It's not going to go in really well between the hairs and so on, which is... You've just watched a 5-minute sample of a live training video. Head to PhotoJoseph.com/store to see the rest of it, as well as the other videos in this series, and to sign up as a member so you have access to the ever-growing library of live training courses.